looking at?
Go get
You ain't wanted in these Murphy Hills.
Shit! Help!
Oh no. Oh no.
Oh God! Help! Help! Help me!
Hey. I thought I'd die with these animals. You're my savior, sir.
Let's go, girl.
Anybody here? Hello?
If you are here to rob me, I wish to make clear that I have weapons that could liquefy each of your internal organs in turn and leave you just a puddle on the floor.
Professor, I ain't here to rob you. It's me. I helped you at the pond?
You did. Oh, you did. The buffoon. Hello.
Hello.
I hope I'm not disturbing you.
Of course you are disturbing me, buddy. I almost solved biggest problem and you mess it up.
Did?
No, but I did. I can't get the bloody conductor straight. The geometry of life. The grand theory of power. It's the grand theory of theories. There is just one more big problem. Maybe I solve it, but can't get it right.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't. Help me adjust these things, and I will show you what I mean. Here, take these.
Oh, well, I'm not much of a scientist.
Well, you are an American. Science is far beyond you. But you make a fine buffoon. Go.
You have the
I wish I ever went to school so I had a clue what was going on. What now?
Well, now, I become the second creature after God himself to bring life to this earth. Like this!
Am I missing something?
The switches. The bloody switches. Okay. Climb up there and adjust them for me. Go quick, please. You ready?
Sure. Second time lucky, eh?
Second time? More like 7,000. This is my life's work. It is incredible. Watch. For now, I am so happy. Oh, you just saw creation's second birth.
I just saw a machine waddle a few steps.
I have a son. I am the luckiest man alive. Those morons, they doubted me.
I'll see you later.
Yes. Yes. Goodbye. Oh.
I better get moving. Must be a way off.
Yep.
Slow it up.
Yep.
There.
How you feeling, ma'am?
Much better than I felt in a long time. If we hadn't caught that rabbit, I don't think I'd have made it another day.
Well, you look better.
Better and determined, thanks to you. And if I'm gonna learn to hunt, I figured it was time I learned how to use Cal's gun properly.
Well, how's that working out for you?
Well, let's just say my prey is looking decidedly unscathed. But the end of labor is to gain leisure. Is that not what Aristotle said?
Well, I don't know much about Aristotle, but well, I know a thing or two about shooting a gun. Look, you gotta hold steady and firm. You just focus, breathe slowly, and always pull the trigger on empty lungs. Here, I'll show you. Okay. Calm and steady. Don't snatch at the trigger.
You make it look so easy.
All right. You try now. Remember to breathe.
Wait to breathe out. Wait to breathe out. Would you look at that? I haven't hit one that close all day.
Not bad. Focus on the inhale. Shoot on the exhale. My turn. I'll shoot a few more this time.
Oh no, that wretched rat is back. Over there, you see? It's been a thorn on my side ever since we moved here. Kill it, please. What can I say? Thank you. But I still have some of the rabbit left that I salted up. Would you join me for a meal? It's the least I can do. Go ahead and take a seat at the table. Food is just about done. Oh. Well, it's good and hot. I hope you enjoy it. You helped me to catch it, after all. Bon appetit. Please enjoy. And thank you again for everything. I really am grateful.
It was nothing.
You're a good man.
Oh, you don't really know me.
I know enough. There's always more to find in ourselves. You helped me to see that. My husband, Cal, was such an optimist. I found that to be very contagious. But there's a fine line between optimism and naivete. And we were both born with a silver spoon. Banquets, butlers, valets.
Sounds terrible.
It was just so many people, so many things. I was lost in it. I was crushed by it. My father was very overbearing. Then we came out here and I got crushed by this. You know, I pictured myself picking fresh vegetables, sipping homemade wine, writing a great novel. But I turned out to be a far more pathetic anti-heroine than any I could ever pen.
Oh, well. I reckon you're gonna be just fine.
Are you all right? Can I get you some water?
No, I'm fine. I just, thank you for this. I think it's best if I make...
Stay right there. It's gonna be okay. My dear Arthur, I have gone out hunting. Not a phrase I thought any pen of mine would ever ink, but nonetheless one I am very proud to finally be able to write. I am so very grateful to you for all the help and encouragement you've given me. There is some money in a box on the nightstand. Please take it. I have far more than I need back in the city, and I'd like you to have it. Please take care, and remain true to the man I know you are.
This what you want?
It's all good. Calm down.
Yeah, you're funny, like a hole in the head.
It's okay.
Yeah. Easy. Easy. Whoa. Easy, girl. Whoa. Easy, easy. Easy now. Easy. You're okay. That's something.
It's been a little while, eh? Would you look at this pale old brute? Must have found him up north, right? Okay, let's take a look at it.
I hope you make good use of that.
Quality hide makes the hardiest clothes around. Don't doubt it. Seem the ambitious type. If you want a unique garment, you need to bring me a unique pelt. It'll be worth it. I wish I never had to take my stall into the city. Just like I wish country folk had any damn money. Okay. lot of folk hunt, but not so many know their way around a needle and thread. It's good business, I'm telling you.
Thanks. Hamish.
Arthur! Come in.
You said, we could go for a hunt.
I did. There's this huge she-wolf been stalking me the last few nights I've been out, but she can wait. Let's talk a while.
Sure.
So what do you do?
Me? I'm a wanderer. I was born further north, but I spent a lot of time out west. Funny, I never saw myself as a wanderer man. But...
The bodies lay so thick, you could have walked across the whole field without your boots touching mud.
Those were bad times.
Yes, they were. Would you like some more coffee?
Please.
Ooh-wee.
What have we here?
Yeah, she's right across there.
That close.
Oh, she's acting brazen. Come on, let's mount up.
Come on. She went around to the left, around the lake. Down here somewhere. You with me? Come on!
Wolves shouldn't come so close to people.
Yeah, it's strange. When the whole country was wild, they could go where they liked. Now they're stuck hiding in the few corners of wilderness we got left.
It's a feeling with which I can sympathize.
This ain't a country for wild animals, nor wild men, neither.
Not anymore, it seems.
You hear that?
Yep.
Quickly now, this way. Up there, on the outcrop, you see her? Let's go around it.
Okay, I'm with you.
We're on to her. Come on.
Okay.
Let's get up to the top. Have a look around from up there. View loves hills, don't you, boy? You eat them up for breakfast. What we got here? Is that a fresh kill?
Could be. Is the blood set?
Let me take a look.
Yep. That was her dinner. Now, where'd she get to?
my guess. She's gone somewhere over there.
Well, there's a whole lot of over there.
That's the problem. There she is. Got shy all of a sudden. You got some extra miles in you tonight?
Oh, if we gotta chase her, let's chase her.
All right. Come on.
Quick, while we got eyes on her. Damn it. Too slow. It looks like she's headed into the wood. We're gonna have to track her through the scrub. Better to be on foot. Send your horse somewhere safe.
Get going, girl. There's a wolf about.
You went in there, all right. We got a tracker. Now, you take the lead, or shall I?
If you don't mind, I'd like to.
Okay, get tracking. I'll be close behind you.
I got the trail.
Right behind you. Take it slow. You see anything yet?
Just tracks.
We heading down here?
We don't. What's the worst that can happen? She runs off with the chicken?
Well, I'm fine with losing chickens, but I lost a leg already. And I gotta pull down my pants to shit in these woods, so.
Yeah, you don't wanna lose that.
Hey, up there. Is that the she-wolf?
Ready to offer my complete and unconditional.
Yeah, I don't think the wolves would have shown much mercy.
That's quite an ambush she led us into.
Yeah, bushwhacking, I'd call it.
Huh? Goddamn! Over here! Over here!
Damn you! Monster
now!
Son of a bitch.
Is that all of them?
That's the best of them. Look at them. Proud thing.
Scary thing. They brought us here to be slaughtered.
You were after a hunt.
Yeah. Yeah, and I guess I got hunted. You going back to the cabin?
Nah. Still early. We'll stay up here a while. Dress this animal. Won't likely see another like him for some time.
Yeah, I hope I won't either. Thanks for taking me out.
Yeah, anytime. You want to go out again? You come by and see me.
So long, then.
Wait. Here's a pelt.
Thank you.
You earned it. So long. He could speak the stories he'd tell. This big. almost a shame we killed it.
Come on, the girl.
Come in. You don't sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
I don't know too much about peace.
Apparently not. Did you have fun with my son, the impetuous prince? I believe you went on a raid with him.
I'm sorry.
I suppose I lack the grandeur of a conventional king.
I don't know too many kings.
Colonel Favors, He has already exacted some measure of revenge for the raid. Two women were assaulted by his men.
I'm very sorry about all of this.
Yes. Sometimes the correct path, the bravest path, is the least obvious and also the gentlest. I'm a great disappointment to my son.
Your son seems to want a war.
My son thinks there is glory in death. Maybe he's right. But for me, I saw death being handed out so freely by the most foolish of men, I never could equate it with victory. Glory has come in service. Maybe. Maybe not, I don't know.
I've killed a lot of people. For a whole lot of dumb reasons, and I ain't never seen much glory in it.
Well, your friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, he talks a lot. I don't know him, but my son is easily led.
I'm not sure I get you.
Well, perhaps we could go for a ride. I'm an old man. My whole life I have tried to bring peace.
But I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please, it won't take long. And maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, do you know my friend, Mr. Morgan?
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose there's much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe.
Sure, I can help.
That's good news. Thank you. Come meet me on the reservation whenever you can. Even just a couple hours of your time. Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you.
Easy, girl.
See the wolves over there feasting on that horse? Brutality and beauty are both all around us. Yet so often we're unable to see past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah! Go on, get out of here!
Good. There was no need to harm them. We can talk if you want, Mr. Morgan. But don't feel like you have to. It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
So, we don't know each other too well, but I wanted to speak to you about your son. I was there on the raid to steal back those horses, and, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes. A little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but I just don't trust it.
Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here. Looking for English mace. Okay, let's continue on.
Now, I was saying, I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought.
You know, I had a son once, years ago. Don't talk about him much.
Oh, what was his name?
Isaac. His mother, Eliza, was a waitress I met. When she got pregnant, she knew who I was, what my life was. I didn't want to promise nothing I couldn't keep, but I said I'd do right by them. Every few months, I'd stop by there for a few days. He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess. Just a kid, 19.
What happened?
I got there one day and saw two crosses outside. I knew right away. Turned out some bastards had come through. Robbed them. Shot them dead. And offered $10. It hardened me, feeling that kind of pain. But I know now that you don't...
Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later. There. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Mix these together. It tastes awful, but it'll help to keep your strength up. Let's go. It's not much further now. You were saying before you rode off?
But I know now that you don't get to live a bad life and have good things happen to you.
I think you're being hard on yourself.
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make some things right. I appreciate the herbs, but I think it's gonna take more than that. I saw a doctor, and he says I'm in a pretty bad way.
I'm sorry to hear that.
This situation we're in, me, Dutch, and the others, I don't know how long I got, but some of them, they still got a chance to have a life. I just think if I could give them that, then maybe this ain't all for nothing.
I think there's much you can still do, Mr. Morgan.